我是中央电视台央视网央视新闻移动网的记者，我想请问一下杨部长有关监察委员会的问题。因为
From CCTV, my question to Minister Yang, talking about the National Supervision Committee, actually that from the NPC as also the national organ. We talk about the goal of reform is to strengthen the party leadership. How do you understand this sentence, or how do we interpret that the that should pay the contribution to the NPC, but also should confirm the supervision job to NPC? Thank you for your question, and also thank you all the media outlets. For the leadership of Party Central Committee and for the socialist country that led people running the country, the big issue is the corruption. After the 18th CPC National Congress and under the leadership of Party Central Committee with Comrade Xi Jinping at its core, we achieved a big progress in this regard. But of course, it's a long-term battle against corruption. We achieved the current success, but we need to achieve the further sweeping success that need our further strengthen of the leadership. This time, we established the National Supervision Committee. Actually, this is shared the office of the Discipline Inspection Commission and report directly to the State Council, and also receive the supervision by the State Council. And this is also produced by the NPC, so it should report the work to NPC and pay responsibility to NPC. It stipulates at how to the top legislature for work report, especially for specific working report, and also for deliberation on by the NPC, and all of these reflects the supervision by the NPC, and we report our work to the State Council, we pay responsibility to the State Council, we work hard in fighting against, we share the office with the Discipline Inspection Commission. All of these reflects the united leadership of the Party Central Committee. These are actually in line with the country's contacts on our system of government, and this reflects our fundamental feature of socialist country. And we also made a change for the commandment to our constitution, and that's also included in the general principle of the constitution. And we also put that the leadership of the NPC over the supervision committee included in the constitution. All of these is conducive to the Party Central Committee's leadership, and we also follow the guidelines of NPC. I believe this is my answer.
From
People's Daily, that talking about the share of the picture, sharing the company or the office, there will be a very supervision big committee. The people have concerns whether that will be a very big superpower organ. The anti-corruption related departments included in the National Supervision Committee. So the national level and the local level supervision departments only add on 10% headcounts. So later on, how to control the power or what's the form of the power. There's actually no big change to the previous discipline inspection commissions. There's no new power extension, but we add more responsibilities. Previously, the anti-corruption work, there is an empty area, is for the people, especially the officials. So the party discipline actually is a high requirement to the party members before. Like the public servants only under the supervision. Actually, the party members or the public servants, we also have a wide range of people. That's also the government officials. We talk about administrative personnel. They're not really under the scope of supervision. So for these empty areas, we include that part into the scope of supervision committee. So through the National Supervision Committee, we watch all the conduct of the people concerned. And based on the pilots running in the each province, so the our workload increased by more than 200%. Which means we have more responsibilities on our shoulder, but that means we are a superpower organ. All our job per day is for the supervision, to give the warning and to prevent the small mistakes into big ones. Of course, and we will give the punishment to the wrongdoing personnel after 18th National Congress. We punished 322 officials. After 19th National Congress, we punished the central governmental level officials and 29 other administration officials. So our punishment is really strong, and we will always keep this environment, let people not do the corruptions. And we will also continue our education to the officials and also strengthen our work in supervision and keep the environment is clean, and all the governmental officials be a good one and prevent them to do any wrongdoings and do the less wrong things.
我是山东广播电视台和闪电新闻的记者 我想问您的问题呢,
是纪委和
Shandong TV, 纪委和监委和办公之后呢, 有人就担忧,
my question is, after sharing the office between National Supervision Committee and the Discipline Inspection Commission, who will take the leading seat? From the people's data, I believe their question is more or less similar to yours, or how to strengthen the National Supervision Commission, or how to supervise the work conducted by all of us. So we joint working, and we all have our corresponding role and responsibilities. And we deal with more cases that the not abide by the law, but the less cases is the criminal cases. So we will do more jobs in the supervision job, that is for our part. And the job is to conduct the surveys and do the investigations. These two are highly complement and reinforced, and they also cannot replace by each other. Talk about the additional departments. We are interconnected, but of course we cannot replace each other. So during our investigation, if we found
提请检察机关对他进行公诉，而检察机关对我们的提请要进行
审查。A crime case,
如果
then we will go to the prosecution department.
可以退回，可以不予起诉。
So if that are not follow the laws, then they will reject our requirements. That's also a kind of supervision on us. So the question from People's Daily, so whether it's how you supervise or monitor yourself, internally we have very strict supervision process and policies. We have an office that's specifically doing this part of job. So they will monitor the personnel from National Supervision Committee, and we also have our internal discipline inspection office. So that the responsibility is given by the party and also the laws. So that really did a lot of job and also deal with a lot of cases in this regard. And we already released information in the report. We also received the supervision and the leadership over the Government Central Committee. And we are the first one to report our job to the central party and also the central government. And we receive the very strict requirements as well as from the NPC by the law, and we will also receive the control or the supervision by the state government, NPC, and also the society as well as the media. Our website, our newspaper, our periodicals actually report our work done in anti-corruption, talking about strictly supervision on party conduct, as well as the supervision on ourselves. We also having the CPPCC, and the supervision within the party and also outside the party is also very effective. So we have very clear role and responsibility and we welcome the supervision from across the board because all of these help us to strengthen our work and improve ourselves. Thank you very much. Thank you, Minister Yang from Supervision.